there could be some setting which forces the recording to start automatically with every meeting. I think in the professional version, the paid version, for it is there. I can make every meeting automatically be recorded. Okay, thank you Sanjeevji for that. So what was I saying? I will say a paragraph for you. Today, let us listen to it and understand. You will understand what does it mean. Next time we will write it down also for together, all of us. Okay. So Sanskritam atyanta sarala bhasha. Sanskritena sambhashanam itopi saralam. Vayam sarve api prayatnen nityajivane sanskritasya upayogam kartu shaknuma. Did you get it? That's it. I think it's three lines that I want to say about the
first line is Hindi.
Sanskrit is a very simple bhasha.
Correct. Sanskrit is a very bhasham. Itopi saralam.
Conversing in
Sanskrit is also very
easy. Is also very easy. And then what did we have? Vayam sarve api. Vayam means we or all of us. Sarve api, all of us. Prayatnen, with means with effort. This is the tritiya. Prayatnen, tritiya vibhakti. And we are going to do vibhaktis today, so you will remember it even more. So vayam sarve api swalpen prayatnen. Last time I did not say swalpen, but this time I am adding that swalpen prayatnen, a little effort.
Little effort.
Nitya jivane, which means
day to day life.
Daily life. Everyday life. Sanskritasya upayogam kartum shaknumah.
It can be brought into your everyday life. The usage can be brought into your everyday life.
So sanskritasya upayogam. We kartum shaknumah. Kartum shaknumah means we can do. Shaknumah is can. We can all use Sanskrit in our daily life with a little effort. And I think we are actually doing, at least on Sundays, we are using Sanskrit for at least one full hour among all of us. And even outside of this kaksha, hopefully you are trying here and there. Even small sentences, or even not even sentences, if you think of, say, what do you call this in Sanskrit, what do you call that in Sanskrit, and start thinking about it, even that helps. Looking at something, for example, when your mother or when your sister or somebody at home is cooking, maybe, or you yourself are cooking, so now you can always say aham pachami, that I am cooking, or mama bhagini pachati, so my sister is cooking. You remember that pacha kriya, it's cooking.
And vadami is for telling, speaking.
Speaking.
Vadami,
yes,
no? Saying. And for eating, bhojan.
Bhikshayami. Bhikshayami. One second. I will write it here on the screen. Bhakshayami.
Bhakshayami.
Even khadami is also used for eating. So you can use them. Both of them are fine.
Acharya Mahode, in future part, Angla Bhasha, not उपयोजन
ओ प्रयत्नम करोमि प्रयत्नम करोमि
भविष्यति
हाँ भविष्य पाठ पाठ आंग्ल
प्रयत्नम करोमि All right. So now let us write. While I am writing this, this comes a lot of times based on your questions. So now this suddenly came into my mind that you might usually do not try this sentence. You normally do not say I try. So, for example, Naveen ji just suggested something. So, we will say, I will try. Because that is a future tense. Now, what do you do for future tense in Sanskrit? So, Kuru is the original Kriya. And you will say, Prayatnam Karishyami. So, this is the future tense. Bhavishyakal, special characters. So, khadishyami, bhakshishyami, vadishyami, likhishyami, pathishyami. So, I will read, I will study. So, ishya, whenever you add to a verb, then it becomes a bhavishyakal. So let us write that. Because most of the Sanskrit that we are learning till today and that will continue for a long time is going to be done for present tense, which is all Vartaman Kal. So normally we are studying in Vartaman Kal because only when you learn basics of a language in one tense, then we will slightly graduate into other tenses, right? I don't want to confuse you with too many tenses like a grammar book at all at the same time. We will use it as we need it. All right. So you normally want to say, I will try. So you will say, Prayatnam Karishyami. Simple phrase, Prayatnam Karishyami.
Acharya, prayatnam karomi is also having meaning, right?
In Sanskrit. Karomi is I try. I am doing it right now. Karomi is right now.
Present. But the sentence is correct.
Ah.
Prayatnam karomi.
I try. Or I am trying. So that is present.
Can you say that kal or vartaman kal?
What was that, Naveen ji?
Vartaman kal.
Your voice was breaking a little bit. Say that again. No.
Is it a vartaman kal ya tatkal?
Both are same. Tatkal is like immediate. Vartaman is present. So, Vartaman actually covers a little more than Tatkal.
Dhanyavada, Acharya
Maharaj. Like how we have a Tatkal reservation in railways.
Yeah, so that is too much immediate. So, very restrictive. But Vartaman is in general. Aham pathami, tvam pathasi. It's not an immediate thing, but you are studying, you are reading. It covers what is going on right now.
Bhavishyakal.
And if you remember, Naveen first used a word in one of his messages on the group. where I think he sent it about the Guru Dakshina, and he said Preshitvan.
Preshitvan, huh?
Sending.
So that is Bhutkal.
Sent.
Kimkal?
Bhutkal.
Bhutkal.
Past tense.
Past. Past tense.
Purvakal galat hai, purva.
No, it should not be wrong. Purvakal, from the name, I mean, from the meaning, I can imagine that Purvakal also means the same thing. And yeah, but I have mostly read Bhutkal in terms of grammatical references to these tenses. It is always Vartaman Kal, Bhavishya Kal, and Bhutkal.
So if I have to say Prayatnam in the past tense, Karotvan. Prayatnam Karotvan. I tried.
Kuruvan. Kuruvan would be more useful. But Bhutkal has many other variations also. So we will try when we reach there. But see, Preshit is a word. Preshan is the original Kriya. So Preshan becomes Preshitvan in Bhutkal for that word. For Karomi or say Likhati, Pathati, Pathitvan or Likhitvan or Kurutvan. So you will have to add the ta and then van to the Kriyas. Likhitvan, Pathitvan.
No, but this word, Acharya, try, for the word try. I tried my best in the past tense. How do I write?
Try is already covered here, na? Prayatnam. So we,
okay.
So you see, in Sanskrit, you have separated the kriya of doing something versus from the prayatna. See, in English, you are seeing the try as the kriya.
Correct.
Right, but here in Sanskrit, Karomi is the Kriya, Prayatnam is the quality of that Kriya.
Yes. So for the
So for Prayatnam, I am not attaching any Bhutkal, Bhavishyakal or Vartaman Kal. Prayatnam is Prayatnam. Now the Kriya, I am adding Karomi, which means I am doing it right now, or I will say Karishyami, which means in the future. So it is different from English. Try not to translate exactly how you write in English to Sanskrit. Otherwise, you will not be able to separate the Kriya correctly. Did you understand what I am saying?
It's the same in Telugu. Prayatnam, like, is the qualifier of
The Kriya.
Kind of Kriya.
Correct.
I think it's the same other languages.
Even in Hindi, we will say koshish karta hun. So koshish is the qualifier and karta hun is the actual verb. So even in Hindi, it is similar to Sanskrit. English is different. So in English, try is a verb. Here, prayatnam is not a verb. Prayatnam is just a qualifier of the actual verb, which is garomi. This is the kriya here. Did you get that, Geetaji?
Yeah, I got confused because we tried to understand Sanskrit through English.
Using
that's
English.
Why.
So yes. Try not to do that.
In Sanskrit,
Naveen, your voice is breaking a lot.
Is it better? No.
Try, try speaking something.
Okay, let me switch off the video.
Now, no, when you said let me switch off the video, it was proper.
Okay.
I don't know what you changed.
You change it. Consuming bandwidth, but
no, it's not about the bandwidth. There is something else because it is still breaking.
Oh.
Let me look.
Everyone else has to mute, I think. Only one person has to talk.
Let's see. I think almost everybody is muted already. So whoever wants to talk, please unmute yourself and then talk. Let's see.
मैं बात करता हूँ तो संस्कृत भारती में क्या बोल रहे हैं उधर आचार्य महोदय कि यू कैन यूज आप हर भारतीय भाषा अपनी मातृभाषा उपयोग करके अनुवाद कर सकते हैं संस्कृत में से अपनी मातृभाषा में मगर आंग्ल भाषा का सेंटेंस फॉर्म में
विधि डिफरेंट है हाँ
इज डिफरेंट तो उससे डोंट ट्रांसलेट यूजिंग इंग्लिश सो उन लोगों का वो दे आर यूजिंग दैट मेथड बिकॉज इफ यू यूज इंग्लिश इट इज नॉट लर्निंग संस्कृत द वे So,
correct
word
exactly so yeah but I think there are I think Geeta ji doesn't understand too much of Hindi she said that in the initial classes so that is why we use some English so that everybody gets yes. it because for
I know it might be difficult
So now is this understood? Vartaman Kal, Bhavishyakal versus Bhutkal. We have not discussed too much, but I wanted to describe this a little. When you just want to say, I will try or I will read, you just add the ish portion to your kriya. Karishyami, Pathishyami or Likhishyami and it becomes future tense. That is understood?
Aam Acharya Mahoday.
Okay. So now let us do Vibhaktis. Let's see if we will be able to write on within this space. Ramam. Ramen so that is Prathama, Dvitiya, Tritiya. I am going to write in Devanagari numbers, Devanagari digits. Have you read Devanagari digits before?
Some of the digits are not visible, Acharya.
Not visible?
They are
concealed with some. Now it's visible.
Okay. Naveenji, you were saying something?
Aham Pashyami.
Okay. Uttamam. So Ramaya
Na Pashyami. No. only the numbers alone.
Aham vichar karomi yo bhavatyaha antarjal antarjalam defective asti. Okay, not defective really, but
numbers are coming behind.
The controls are there. The zoom controls is coming behind that.
No, I am writing the numbers later than the words. So I am aham shabdani shabdaha likhami.
पश्यसि
वा
पश्यसि अहं पश्यामि
ओके
पश्यामि बट फ्रॉम फोर्थ फोर्थ नॉट फर्स्ट सेकंड एंड थर्ड
दैट इज स्ट्रेंज ओके
द आइकॉन्स आर टचिंग
मम यवनिका
नंबर्स आर फाइन बट दे आर कमिंग देयर इज एक मेन्यू
पंचमी
हाउ अबाउट यू संजीव जी आर यू एबल टू सी ऑल द नंबर्स एंड वर्ड्स प्रॉपर्ली
So I was having problem. The Zoom, the toolbar was blocking that view. So I've changed the view on my screen.
Okay, your own setting or something. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. That in the screen that Zoom options are there. The plus minus one toolbar is coming. So that is blocking the view. So you can change the view, Geeta Mahodaya.
I changed. I got it now. Sometimes it just comes. The icons just come.
So Shashti is Ramasya. Shashti is something very commonly used, and actually you can use all of them depending on the need. But Shashti is also something we will study as much as time permits today. And the final one is Sambodhan, which is Hey Ram. And just before that, it was Saptami. So, Saptami. Saptami is this. And Panchami, Shashti, Saptami, Ashtami. All right, so these are the eight vibhaktis. Now we will also write prayogaha. So first prayogaha, ಆಮೇಲೆ ವಾಕ್ಯ ನೌ ಐ ನ್ಯೂ ಬಾಬಾಜಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಗೀತಾಜಿ ವುಡ್ ಸ್ಮೈಲ್ ವಿತ್ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅಂಡ್ ಈವನ್ ಸಂಜೀವ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಬಬ್ಲಿ ನಮಿತ್ಜಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ
ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಪಶ್ಯಾಸಿ
No, Kannada Bharate. Kannada. Kannada Jana.
I tried to ask him whether he knows Valpa Kannada in Sanskrit.
Aham Kannada Bhasha. Aham Kannada Bhasha Janami.
Janami. Kannadam Janami. So when you want to say I don't know much, so aham na janami, you can simply say. And when you want to say I know, then you can say aham janami. You can add the name of the language if you want to, but aham janami or aham na janami is good enough. Okay, so now we will write the usage of each of these vibhaktis, which means when do you use each of them. All right, so prathama ne. So in Hindi it comes easier. In English there is nothing to describe the ne, because you can just say the doer, the karta. So when the Ram is the karta, the person who is doing things, then you will simply say Ramah. So something like Ramah vadati. This is an example sentence. So I will say vakya using that vibhakti. Ramam is Ram ko, so which means you are doing something to Ram, or something is happening to Ram. So then it
I will also suggest I will also suggest for non-Hindi speakers or people who don't know Hindi, they can also write these translations in their own mother tongue. They're almost same. I mean, like, you can write it in your mother tongue so that you will understand the usage, the way to use the vibhaktis better.
And I'm trying to write in Hindi, Sanskrit and English. So whoever can utilize whatever method, it's up to you.
Uttama.
So when the Ram is doer, which means the karta, then you will simply say Ramah or Sanskritah or Vrikshah. Ramam is something to be done to Ram. All right, and let us write something which does not have to use Ramam only, but we will use something which is similar. So for example, let me write an example and then you will know what I am saying. So for the Dvitiya, I am going to write a different example. Instead of using Ramam, I am saying Aham. And you can also write the examples with you on your sheets and say it along. Aham. And when I write it, then you will suddenly realize that, oh, we have used this so much. Pustakam pathami. So now do you see pustakam? Because you are reading the book. So the book is being worked on. Book is the karma. You are doing the reading to the book. So that is why pustakam is Dvitiya Vibhakti. And that also tells you that Pustak and Ram are two similar Akarant Pulling Shabd. So that is why their Vibhaktis run the same. So Ramah Ramam or Pustakah Pustakam Pustaken, same way, it goes the same way. Now Tritiya is Ke Dwara. So do you understand Dwara? People who don't know much of Hindi, do you understand what is Dwara? Or I will write in English also.
By Rama.
Through or by?
Through Rama. Via Rama.
Via. So let us underline the vibhakti. Okay, let me use another color actually. Underline the vibhakti usage part. Sanjeevah. Kalmen likhati. Okay, now I am hoping that you will find a question right on this Tritiya. Let's see if anybody has a doubt.
Kalam, an Urdu word?
No, kalam is a Hindi word. Actually, Hindi is a mixture of... Hindi does use a lot of Urdu words also. So, it's mixed up. But for kalam, there are multiple words. You have lekhani also.
Lekhani
is also there. Ankini is also there. So
Ankini is pencil.
Pencil.
Ankini is pencil. Lekhani is pen.
Lekhani. But the vibhakti of lekhani will run.
अवश्य करोसि
सर योर वीडियो इज स्टिल नॉट देयर
इट्स नॉट वर्किंग प्रयत्नम करोमि
उत्तमम उत्तमम आम मोहा महोदय
यहाँ पे आपने जो बोला है संजीव कलमेन लिखति तो ये कलम के द्वारा लिख रहे हैं राइट
करेक्ट
सो
इवन से
अगर इसे बोलना है संजीव कलम से लिख रहा है या लिख रहे हैं संजीव कलम से लिख रहे हैं
से इज आल्सो देयर इन तृतीया सो इन
सेकंड
से और के द्वारा via, through, by, all of these are tritiya.
So, lekhani padam padani.
So what I was saying just before we got disconnected is lekhani is a ikarant strilling shabd. And that is a completely different word for which vibhakti is also run differently. So, we are not going to try the vibhakti of that one right now.
Asito.
Even lekhani and even ankini. So, ankini is also...
Striling. Ankini is striling.
Ikarant striling shabd. So, vibhaktis are different. So, let us understand one type of vibhaktis first. Then we will go on to others.
अस्तु
नमो नमः संजीव जी गीता महोदय हेमंत महोदय ओके इज एवरीबॉडी एबल टू हियर एंड सी माय स्क्रीन मम जवनिका पश्यसि वा
पश्यामि
उत्तमम नाउ द क्वेश्चन आई वाज hoping for you to ask is this rana in Ramen, yeah, you can see the na, and in Kalamen, you can see the na. See the difference. And it runs in few other words also, which we will learn later. In Bahuvachan of many words, the same rule applies. So once you understand the rule, then you will be able to apply it in other places also. And it's a simple rule. Wherever you have R, Sh, or Sh, the Sh.
So, what is the Tritiya Vibhakti of Lekhani Acharya? Now, in only for this you tell. Anyway, we will learn of everything.
Great question. We are leaving out the Vibhaktis of Ikarant Shabd right now. Because today we are taking two of them, Akarant Pulling and Akarant Striling. So even if we understand just those two, that would be a big achievement for us. So for Lekhani and Ankani, we'll leave it for now. But yes, yeah, you can definitely pick it up as a homework for yourself. So find out all the Bhaktis of the Ikarant Striling Shabd.
Okay.
And you can bring it to the next class for everybody's benefit.
So
wherever you see Ra, Sha, or Sha, these three letters, any of these three vyanjanams in the word. So in Ramen, not Ramen, the Ram Shabd, the original Shabd Ram, has R in it. So that is why the Tritiya, which should otherwise contain the N at the end, it becomes Ena whenever the word contains R, Sh, or Sh.
Traveling, if I want to write Sanjeevaha Vahanena Chalayati or Pravasayati or Sancharishyati, Sancharayati, sorry.
Vahanena Gatsati. So if you just want to say he's going on a vehicle or using a vehicle, you can just say Vahanena Gatsati. But if you want to say Sanjeev Vahanena, means he is driving the vehicle, then it will not be Vahanena, because he is not driving through the vehicle. You will say Sanjeeva Vahanam Chalayati. So now Chalayati is driving, Chalati is just walking, or right, or Gachati is simply going, but Chalayati means driving. So there are slight variations of the words, and they change the meaning.
Acharya, I didn't understand that Arkani, what is that?
Ankani. First Ankani, okay. Thing is, this is the Anga. You remember when we practiced the full Varnamala in one of our initial classes? Ka, kha, ga, gha, Anga. This is the Ka Varg.
Okay.
Ankani. So Ankani is pencil. And Lekhani is pen. And Kalam is actually multi-purpose. So Kalam in Hindi also is used for every anything that you use to write. So it's not necessarily a pencil or a pen. Kalam is anything that you can use to write. So Kalam is more universal, that is why it's easier to use.
I just tried to Google, so I saw Kalam, normal jo hota usage, usme maine dekha anuswar hai. Sorry, anuswar, Kalam.
Correct, so because Kalam is like Rama. So Akarant Pulling Shabd, Kalam. So तो कलमः कलमम् कलमेन कलमाय कलमात् कलमस्य सिमिलर टू राम द विभक्तिज ऑफ कलम विल आल्सो लर्न सो व्हाट वी आर डूइंग टू थिंग्स विद दिस एक्सरसाइज वी आर लर्निंग विभक्तिज वी आर मेकिंग सेंटेंसेस एंड वी आर आल्सो लर्निंग अदर अकारांत पुल्लिंग शब्द आल्सो विच रन द सिमिलर टाइप ऑफ विभक्तिज similar to Ram or similar to Vriksh or similar to Sanskrit all have same type of vibhaktis because they are all akarant pulling shabd.
Acharya, can you repeat that the vibhakti with Ramena?
Hmm.
You said Ra, Sha and Sha.
Hmm.
What is the corroboration with this? What did you say? I didn't understand.
Whenever the original शब्द कंटेन्स र श और श इन राम द राम राम हैज र राइट सो दैट इज व्हाई द तृतीय विभक्ति बिकम्स रामेण इंस्टेड ऑफ रामेन सो यू कैन सी इन कलमेन इट इज न नॉट ण बिकॉज कलम डज नॉट हैव आइदर र श और श राइट Even Pustakam. So even Pustak does not have Ra, Sha or Sha. So when you make a Tritiya of Pustakam, then you will make it Pustakena, not Pustakena. Ana will appear only in case of these three letters in the original word, in the original Sha.
Okay. Okay, I understood. Dhanyavaad.
Is that understood for others also? Hemant ji, Vaibhavi ji, Moha, Mahodaya. संजीव महोदय
आम आचार्य
नवीन जी
आम आम
आचार्य
ओके गुड ऑल राइट सो तृतीय इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट वन गुड दैट वी स्पेंट सो मच टाइम ऑन दैट नाउ रामाय सो प्रथमा ने द्वितीय को तृतीय से और के द्वारा चतुर्थी के लिए सो के लिए इज फॉर So, let us write a nice sentence. Mata Putraya. Now, I am not being gender biased. It's just that Putra is easier to make right now because we are studying the Karant Pulling Shabd. Mata Putraya Phalam. Nayati. Now we are learning two new words here. Phalam, actually, I should be writing like this. But sometimes, just for convenience, if you are writing with a dot with the anuswar on the top, it is okay. But don't make it a practice. Convenience in the sense when you have to be a quick in writing, then you can use that. Vaibhaviji.
I was taught in my school that we have to use the dot if it is not the end of the sentence, and artha matra ma if it is the end of the sentence, if it is the last word in the sentence. So this is what was taught to us.
Okay, we will research more on that. I think you can all take that as a homework as well. But if you can see here also, even aham or pustakam, lot of words we read in other texts also that tat mam pustakam asti. So when you have this kind of sentence, even then pustakam is written with a full ma. Without the anuswar. So I have seen all kinds of text. So before we standardize a rule, let us find out from I hope Sanskrit Bharati will definitely have an answer. So maybe Naveen ji can ask in his class also, because Sanskrit Bharati has one of the greatest, very senior
teachers.
Graduates, teachers, there are thousands of people, nice people. So
Kim Prashna,
did you get that?
Kim Prashnaha, Prashnaha Kim.
Okay, so Vaibhavi ji just informed us that in her school she was informed that when you have words with a ma, like phalam, pustakam, towards the
end. You are breaking up Acharya Mohan.
Oh, one second. Am I still breaking up?
No.
Not breaking up? Okay.
And are you recording, Acharya?
What was that?
Recording?
Recording is happening, yes. This time we started. So what Vaibhavi ji has been told in school is whenever you have these words like Ramam, Pustakam, Phalam at the end of a sentence, then you use the ma, full ma. And if it is coming in the middle of a sentence, then you can use the anuswar. But I have seen usage different from that also. Although what she is saying may be also a good use of that method, ma, where to use ma versus where to use anuswar. But I have seen other usages also. So that is why we are just taking that as a homework, that if we can find out all of us, each of us, if this kind of rule can be universally used, then that will be useful. Thank you, Vaibhavi ji, for bringing this up. Somebody is echoing a lot. Is that you? Naveen ji, you are saying something?
No.
Okay.
I think.
Okay, so you got this one. Mata Putraya Phalam Nayati. Now let me first underline and then we will discuss it. Putraya is the Chaturthi Vibhakti, which means Putra ke liye or for the son. So Mata brings, not brings, takes. Nayati is she takes. Anayati is brings. So when you say anaya, then it is the bringing kriya. And naya is taking. Let me change the color first. Okay. Let us write that difference also here. Anaya means bring. And naya is take. Sumata putraya phalam nayati. Is this understandable? Easy?
Aam Acharya Mahoday.
And we just found out that Ram, Pustak, Kalam and Putra, all four of these have same type of vibhaktis for them, right? Because they are all akarant pulling shabd. Okay, now
and avagan,
what was that?
Aham, understand. How do you say it? Understand. I understand. Aham avag avagahami.
Avagat is, it is same as janami. You can even say janami. Janami is a little crude to use here. Avagatami is fine.
Janami is like,
right? I already know. Janami is I already know. But understand is, avagatami is also open.
Acharya ji, isko sentence ko can you please translate once in Hindi, this entire sentence?
Mata,
Hindi and English.
Praya, alam, nayat. Means mata, putra ke liye, or mata, for the son. Phalam nayati, it's fruit. So, mata putr ke liye phal le jaati hai.
Okay. I'll tell you what I was thinking. Main soch rahi thi ki phal matlab putr ki kamna karti hai. That's why I was badly confused.
That can be done, but key will be this shashti.
So, isliye mujhe wo takes samajh mein nahi aa raha tha ki takes aaya kahan pe.
So shashti is kaketi or off.
So nahi ke liye aapne jo likha tha na, to maine socha ki ke liye matlab mata putra ke liye kamna karti hai aise, isliye maine bola ki hindi mein boliye to mujhe samajh mein aayega.
हाँ, if you said माता पुत्राय कामना करोति, then it will be that what you just said. पुत्र के लिए कामना करती है. अभी right, she is just taking fruit for her son, which means कामना is already पूर्ण. That is why
पुत्र is already there.
Okay, so now panchami. Pachmane dvitiya ko tritiya se ekve dwara chaturthi ke liye panchami. Panchami is also a se, but this is a separation. Alag hone wala shabd hai. So this is more like, okay, from, separate from. This is also used for comparison, tulana. But let us learn the basic first meaning of that first with the sentence. Phalam Vrikshat Patiti. Vrikshat Patati. So now, because phal is separating from the tree, so vrikshat is from the tree, so that is why you have vrikshat. And patati, did we learn patati earlier? False. दिस इज अंडरस्टूड
फल वृक्ष से गिर रहा है
गिरता है और गिर रहा है यू कैन से फलम और यू कैन से पत्रम पत्रम वृक्षात पतति विच मींस द लीव्स आर द लीफ इज फॉलिंग फ्रॉम द नाउ षष्ठी विच इज रामस्य षष्ठी मीन्स का केकी सो ऑफ राम and depending on the pulling striling or napunsakling and depending on the pluralism vachan bahuvachan bahuvachan you would use ka or ke or ki in hindi but in sanskrit it is all ramasya phalasya vrikshasya okay So now, example of this one, etat navinasya. पुस्तकम् अस्ति चेंज द कलर ओके एंड नाउ वी बिफोर वी गो टू द नेक्स्ट few we will practice the shashti because shashti is one of the very very common vibhaktis that you will come across all right off is a very commonly used word so I will say something and then I will ask you a question and you will find it easy to answer so let's try a few मम देशस्य नाम भारतः दिल्ली भारतस्य राजधानी दिल्ली कस्य राजधानी गीता महोदया
दिल्ली भारतस्य राजधानी
ओके नाउ कैन यू आस्क समथिंग विद कस्य to somebody else
moha mahodaya tava bhartya kutra vasati
once more
mujhe nahi aapka sentence pura aaya geeta ji can you please repeat I can't hear you properly
moha mahodaya भारतः भारत भारतस्य किं प्रदेश वसति
वससि बिकॉज यू आर आस्किंग मोहन
वससि
पत्याः
भारतस्य किं प्रदेशः वसति
प्रदेशे Now you are actually using a longer sentence and it has to use multiple vibhaktis. So you want to ask which state, right? So inside which state does he live? So Bharata says correct, but Pradesha would not be
suitable. Pradesha would Pradesha.
Because that is the next vibhakti. We haven't reached there, so that you have used the next vibhakti already.
Okay,
how do we have it is just Telangana Pradeshi, right? That is the only answer I'll be giving.
Aham Bharatasya Telangana Pradesh Vasami. If you want to answer exactly how she asked, then you can say Bharatasya Telangana Pradesh. Otherwise, you can just say Telangana Pradesh also. That is up to you. Answer is all in your control.
Aham Bharatasya Telangana Pradesh Vasami.
What was that?
Can I use Kutra also?
Yeah, you can ask Bhavatyaha Kutra Vasasi.
Also, my friend said, when I got a doubt, Kutra is not right. That's why I said,
your voice has a lot of disturbance going on. Let me see. Let us mute others. Okay, now can you ask again?
I had a self-doubt whether I should use Kutra or Kim. So first sentence I asked Bharatasya Kutra Pradeshe Vasasi.
No.
Then I changed it to Kim Pradeshe.
Kim Pradesh is correct, okay. Because you want to ask which state, and what is Kim in Sanskrit. Kutra is directly where. So now when you say where cannot have a state as a qualifier separately. So after where you cannot use a state, but you want to ask which state exactly, right? So then Kim Pradesh is more correct. Kutra Pradesh does not even mean anything. If you just want to use Kutra, then you don't use Pradeshe or anything else. You will just say Kutra Vasasi. Bhavatyaha Kutra Vasasi. Then it is correct. Kutra cannot take the specific areas in the sentence. Okay, so now Mohaji, can you ask similar question and maybe a shorter question? Like I asked Gitaji, Delhi kasya rajdhani?
I will try.
Meanwhile, I am writing example for Saptami also because you already used it. Gitaji just used it.
Sanjeev Mahode, Kashmirasya Kim Bhasha.
That is also enough.
In what language do they talk is what I'm saying. Kashmirasya Kim Bhasha
Vadatu. Vadati.
Nahi, Vadati you cannot use because you are not talking about people. So you are directly saying Kashmirasya Kim Bhasha, right? So
Prayogyati.
Prayoga Bhavati, that is also okay. Or Kim Bhasha Asti, that is also enough. Kashmir Asya Kim Bhasha Asti, which means what is the language of Kashmir?
You are asking the question again, Mahadaya?
Yes, Sanjeev ji. Kashmir Asya Kim Bhasha?
Even that is a full question, so you don't have to add something to it, Mohammadia. Kashmir Asya Kim
Bhasha? But I'm just trying to form. So Kashmir mein kaun si bhasha boli jati hai is what I'm trying to say.
I requested you long, shorter sentence and you are trying to make it even longer than Gita ji. Boli jati hai is an advanced usage and it's okay not to use it right now. Otherwise, you can say Kashmirasya Janaha Kim Bhasha Vadanti. So then it is more complete that what do people of Kashmir speak? So Kashmirasya Janaha Kim Bhasha Vadanti.
Yes, Sanjeev ji.
Kashmirasya. What was that word for people?
Janaha. Janaha.
Janaha. Kashmirasya Janaha Dogra Bhasha
Your voice is not coming, Sanjeevji.
I wasn't saying anything. Thinking what to say.
Asti. Kashmir Asya Janaha Dogra or Dogri, I think Dogri, ne? Or Dogra.
Dogri.
Dogri Bhasha Asti.
Dogri Bhasha. Kashmir Asya.
Or Vadanti. So Kashmir Asya Janaha Dogri Bhasha Vadanti.
Kashmir Asya Janaha Dogri Bhasha Asti.
Okay, now there is a slight difference in usage. When you want to say Kashmirasya Bhasha Dogri Asti, then it is the language of Kashmir which is Dogri. Correct. But when you are saying Kashmirasya Janaha, so now you have to describe the Janaha at the end. So this time when we say Kashmirasya Janaha Dogri Bhasha, then Asti is for the language, but you have to describe the Janaha, right? People, so instead of Asti, you would say Vadanti, because you have to describe what the people do.
Kashmirasya Janaha Dogri Bhasha Vadanti.
Okay, now you ask somebody else something that uses Prachati Vibhakti.
When you have a question, Kim, it becomes Vadanti. Answer it will become Jana Bhasha Vadami.
Vadanti, because you are still talking about the other people, right? For you also, it is other people. And
so, the question and the answer is Vadanti. Sorry.
What's that, Gita ji?
The question and the answer both will have Vadanti only.
Because the person you are talking to and the person who is asking the question,
the people,
are separate people, and you are in both question and answer, you are talking about somebody else all the time. So that is why the Vadanti will remain Vadanti. Only if you were talking to each other or about each other, then Vadami or Vadasi, those things will change depending on who is answering.
Geeta Mahodaya, Bhavatyaha Prabhasha Kim?
एक और बार बोलिए ब्रेक
शी स्पीक्स गुड इंग्लिश
भवत्या
आई डिड हियर
नवीन जी योर वॉइस इज स्टिल ब्रेकिंग आई थिंक इट इज
गीता महोदय भवत्याः मातृभाषा किम्
मातृभाषा तेलुगु
धन्यवादः
उत्तमम् उत्तमम् नवीन जी फाउंड वन मोर तेलुगु स्पीकिंग पर्सन
Adam, right? For making Geeta Mahodaya understand better.
Actually, that is useful.
And the Skrutam Vak. Yeah.
Okay. Idanim Aham Prichami Vaibhavi Mahodaya. रामः दशरथस्य पुत्रः कृष्णः कस्य पुत्रः
कृष्णः वसुदेवस्य पुत्रः
उत्तमम्
उत्तमम्
नाउ हेमंत जी इज रिमेनिंग सो वैभवी जी जस्ट आस्क समथिंग
इवन आई एम रिमेनिंग
Okay. you jumped in between. So, okay. So, Vaibhavi ji asks Hemant ji and then Hemant ji will pass it on to you.
Okay. What is company in Sanskrit?
Company, what company? Like Infosys, Wipro, these companies? You can use a more generic word like karyalay. So, Kim Karyalay, if you want to ask.
I will just ask. Hemant Mahodaya, Bhavatah Duravani Kasya Karyalayasya Asti. I want to know which company
Uttamam.
His phone is.
Uttamam. Duravani.
I understand the
once more Vaibhavi ji
Mant Mahodayah Bhavatah Duravani Kasya Karyalayasya
What is Duravani?
Duravani phone. Telephone. Meant telephone here, but Cell
phone,
there is no word, I think.
Durvani is Durvani. Any phone is fine. So.
Durvani or Durvani.
See, we are making a Durvani here on the screen also. Hemanji for you.
Okay. Vadatu, Hemant Mahodaya.
What exactly the question is?
भवतः दूरवाणी कस्य कार्यालयस्य अस्ति विच कंपनी इज योर फोन
आईफोन अस्ति
एप्पल अस्ति
संस्कृत भाषे वदतु
I sevas or apple.
Apple as
you can say. Apple.
Mama Durvani. Yeah. Apple as
apple.
No.
Apple.
Say I was saying apple as a slave. So sevas.
से नो यू डोंट हैव टू ट्रांसलेट बिकॉज़ देन इट बिकम्स अ फ्रूट बट इट इज गुड एक्चुअली यू कैन मेक जोक्स इन संस्कृत राइट वी ऑलवेज डू इन आवर क्लास यू कैन ऑलवेज से बट देन इट इज सेवी सेवी फलम सो व्हेन व्हेन यू वांट टू मेक अ जोक देन सेव अ फलम इज द word for
okay
then you can just save falasya asti then it works so did you answer is Vaibhaviji satisfied
I didn't hear I mean it was cut but what did he say
हेमंजी
कार्यालयस्य अस्ति
उत्तमम् बट दिस इज अ गुड थिंग वैभवीजी इफ यू कैन टेक इट ऑन योरसेल्फ व्हाट सो बिकॉज़ यूजिंग दैट कंपनी एज अ कार्यालय साउंड्स अ लिटिल क्रूड फॉर संस्कृत सो इफ यू कैन फाइंड आउट हाउ इज अ बेटर यूसेज फॉर दैट
व्यवस्थस्य व्यवस्था
फॉर कंपनी
नो ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज व्यवस्था राइट ऑर्गेनाइज
व्यवस्था नो
मोर ऑफ अ स्पेसिफिक वर्ड फॉर ब्रांड
आई हैव दैट आंग्ल संस्कृत शब्दकोश आल्सो आई विल सी इफ दैट हैज इट राइट नाउ इट इज नॉट नेक्स्ट टू मी I'll also try that. But that is one important thing to get. If you have not ordered yet, please order at least that Shabdakosh for yourself. The Anglo-Sanskrit Shabdakosh and the Hindi-Sanskrit Shabdakosh. There are others also. There are Kannada-Sanskrit Shabdakosh also and some others also on Sanskrit Bhakti website. If you remember, I sent a photo also of that. So please get it because that is a super shabdakosh
acharasya kala
nam kala
say your drawing is very good you've drawn very well
bhavatah
kala ha acharyasya kala uttamam asti
uttamam asti
or you can say sarvottamam asti
सम्यक्
यस् सम्यक् इस् कम्प्लीट्
गुड्
ओके नौ सप्तमी सप्तमी
महोदय प्रश्नः
हा हा हेमन्त महोदय प्रश्नः कुरु प्रश्नः पृच्छतु
किं किं देशे वससि भवता नवीन जी
अमेरिका देशस्य वसामि
देशे राइट देशस्य
क्षम्यताम् अहम् अमेरिका देशे कवर्मौण्ट् नगरे वसामि
नौ यू केन् से देशस्य अमेरिका देशस्य फ्लवर् मौण्ट् नगरे दट्स् वाट् यू सेड्
आम् आम् फ्लवर् मौण्ट् नगरे वसामि
ओके
आगच्छामि
मम प्रश्नः
हा गीता जी हैज टू लीव
भोजनं प्रबन्धं करोमि
उत्तमम् उत्तमम् सो
नमस्कारम्
नमस्कारम् शुभरात्रि नमो नमः गीता महोदय एंड नवीन जी यू कैन आस्क योर क्वेश्चन एंड देन वी विल एंड आफ्टर
अस्तु आचार्य महोदय पश्यसि वा
पश्चामी
तब यवन का करेक्ट करेक्ट ओ सेम सिमिलर शब्द कोश
आई एम आस्किंग आचार्य महोदय और एवरीवन मम यवनिका पश्यसि ओ पश्य यू आर आंसरिंग पश्यामि हां ओके एतत् पुस्तकम् आचार्यस्य पुस्तकं वा
अभ्यास पुस्तकम्
एतत् पुस्तकम् आचार्यस्य पुस्तकं वा
न मम पुस्तकम् अभ्यास पुस्तिका नास्ति मम पुस्तिका आंग्ल संस्कृत शब्दकोशः अस्ति
अस्तु धन्यवादः
So we can stop here because Gita ji has left. So we will cover the Saptami and Ashtami in the next class. I was thinking that we will be able to cover two separate vibhaktis like Akarant Pulling and Akarant Striling also together today. But with examples and with all the discussions, it is good that we are doing this. So next class we will cover the Akarant Striling vibhaktis with examples. Similar in a similar fashion.
I think better we spend more time in vibhaktis because that is very important, right?
Yes, very important, and they are used in every sentence. So, depending on what we are speaking, I always try to make sure we use the right vibhaktis and try to keep correcting here and there. All right, Sarvesham Namo Namah. शुभरात्रि
शुभरात्रि
नमो नमः
शुभरात्रि शुभरात्रि